you gonna do? Yeah. Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you?
The CHS Pulse is filmed on location with the men and women of L15.
Happy New Year and welcome back to the CHS Pulse. I'm Steven Stromberg.
And I'm Carly Becker. We have a great episode to start off 2018.
What's your favorite memory of 2017?
I can't decide. There was so much that happened.
Well, let's see what everyone else has to say about the past year.
What was the best fashion trend of 2017?
Male rompers.
What was the worst fashion trend of 2017?
Definitely Mike Fornaro.
How do you feel about Jelena getting back together?
Personally, I am very excited because they've always been together and I'm a huge Justin fan, so I'm happy for them.
I feel great about it.
I'm really happy about it.
Me too. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when I say fidget spinner?
Ugly.
Why? What's the first thing that comes to your mind when I say bottle flip?
Oh, I don't know, annoying kids.
What was your most memorable moment of 2017?
Summer.
Gonna have to agree.
Getting into college. I haven't gone to college. Won't you? We can
bring it on the floor. Never dance like. What do you think is the fashion trend of the year? Male rompers, velvet, knee-high boots, or clout goggles?
Definitely male rompers.
Clout goggles. Clout goggles.
Clout goggles.
Knee-high boots.
Clout goggles. What do you think should be movie of the year? Get Out, Beauty and the Beast, It, or Dunkirk?
I'm gonna go with Get Out because I haven't seen it.
Dunkirk.
It.
Beauty and the Beast.
It.
Oh, Beauty and the Beast. Come on.
What do you think meme of the year should be? Distracted boyfriend, Arthur, Shook SpongeBob, or Evil Kermit?
SpongeBob.
I think definitely Arthur.
Shook SpongeBob.
Shook SpongeBob.
Evil Kermit.
Distracted boyfriend.
Evil Kermit.
What do you think song of the year should be? Congratulations, Feel It Still, Shape of You, Humble, or Despacito?
Shape of You. I agree. Shape of You by Ed Sheeran.
Despacito.
Humble.
Despacito.
Yeah,
Despacito.
Despacito, I think. Good song.
Wow, 2017 was so lit. I can't wait to see what this year brings.
Lit?
Come on, Carly. Don't you know what lit means?
Don't be salty. Of course I know what it means. But let's see if these teachers can figure out some of the slang and trends from 2017.
Goat?
Yes.
Like the animal goat?
Yes. And it's an acronym for something.
Goat is the last person in the class. Or a failure.
Go? It's got to start with go. No, it doesn't start with go. Does it start with go? Can you give me a hint?
Go?
Goat.
Goat.
Yes.
Not the animal goat.
No.
I honestly have no idea. I can't even guess.
Is it like FOMO?
It's an acronym.
Acronym. I have no idea. Salty?
Yes. It's an adjective.
Yeah, salty, sassy.
Salty. Salty, that seems like...
real salty dog.
Angry or, bitter?
Salty could be, the language they use is a little salty, a little rough, a little coarse.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Sassy.
Shook? Shook me all night long?
Shook. Scared.
Shocked.
Yeah.
It's like shocked.
Shocked. Okay.
Wait, somebody dances maybe?
Woke.
To wake up. Woke from a slumber.
No idea.
Doesn't have anything to do with being conscious?
Woke from bed, no.
Aware? Yeah?
Yeah.
T. Another acronym?
Can't even guess.
Gossip.
Yes.
That's a major gossip to spell.
What's the T?
Yeah.
What's the T? I don't know. What's the take? Triggered. I've heard that one.
Anger triggered?
Apparently, I guess a lot of the things I say trigger people. I don't know.
She set me off? Something set me off. It triggered me.
Made to do something. Something to do with Snapchat. I don't know.
Full send.
Has to do with email?
I have no idea.
Instagram?
Full stop. I have no idea.
We're not sending anything?
I've said what you want to say, and you are sending it?
Give me the 411.
Clout.
Well, clout normally means you've got the clout, you've got the money, you've got the power.
Person's reputation.
They've got the respect and the authority of the other person.
The amount of influence they have. This looks like, it looks like a pink egg, pink dinosaur egg, but I'm gonna guess it has something to do with makeup.
Looks like a purple egg, obviously, but it's probably not. Is it a logo for a tweet?
A beauty blender. Okay. That's 11.
Yeah.
Yep.
This kid's scary. Probably from Stranger Things.
That's 11 from Stranger Things.
He just died.
Oh, God.
I can't remember it.
This is a rapper?
Rappers.
Yeah.
Not me.
Lil Peep. Of course. Okay. Well, it's a hot dog wearing headphones.
You know what it's from?
I have no idea what it's from.
Obviously a hot dog with the headphones on, but I have no idea who it is.
All right. This guy. I don't know who that guy is.
Probably somebody from One Direction.
Catch me outside.
She's scary. He's very scary.
Oh, something from Dr. Phil.
No idea.
Is she a teen mom?
Danielle something.
Those are some pretty interesting guesses.
Hey Carly, did you do anything over, any shopping over break?
Yeah, I actually ran into some designers from Catwalk at the thrift shop.
What were they doing there?
Haven't you heard? Students in Catwalk designed clothes for a fashion show in February.
Let's check out how they're preparing for their show this year.
Is a program that you can join to design clothes for the fashion show.
We design clothes based off of like a certain theme that we have, and so we have to come up with a design and fit our models to make an outfit for the show.
It involves knowing how to sew and being able to use your skills.
You basically have to either pick fabrics or like pick an outfit that you want to make, and then you have to figure out how to sew it and fit it to your model and kind of make an original design.
This year, instead of going to a fabric store and getting a certain amount of fabric and buttons and getting a pattern that'll like tell you how to make the outfit, we went to a thrift store
and buy thrift clothes, and our task is to make a prom dress out of them. So you kind of have to like cut everything apart and then redo it from scratch and kind of figure it out.
It's definitely a new challenge, but I think it'll be fun. A bunch of my friends did Catwalk freshman year, so I joined sophomore year.
And I just wanted to do it because it was something very different, and I always enjoyed sewing in middle school.
I like it because you can express yourself in the form of clothing and really make whatever you want to make.
Those designs look great. Good luck to all the designers at the Catwalk this year.
Hey Steven, have you made any New Year's resolutions yet?
Of course. New year, new me, right?
Yeah, I'm having trouble coming up with my own though.
Maybe you'll get some ideas from the other students at CHS. Let's see what they hope to achieve in the new year.
What's your New Year's resolution?
I'm going vegetarian 2018.
Win a lot in gym volleyball.
Yeah.
Never lose.
Yeah.
We don't lose.
It's almost hard. Yeah. It's not even fun anymore.
It's a curse. It's too easy out here. It's a curse.
I'm just looking forward to being home and my home on the eastern shore of Virginia.
It's too far in advance to answer that question. I don't know. What am I looking forward to in 2018? A huge snowfall.
My resolution is to try to spend more time with my family.
Eagles to get a Super Bowl. Go Birds.
Yeah, Philadelphia Eagles to win a Super Bowl.
To win a Madden Cup.
To make high honor roll.
I'm looking forward to getting into college.
What do you look forward to in 2018?
In 2018, I look forward to continue high school
and, you know, taking the next step.
I'll be 17 in May, which is my birthday, and then maybe I'll get my learner's permit finally, and I'll finally learn how to drive.
What is your New Year's resolution?
To see less of Clay.
Thank you. All right, John, what do you look forward to in 2018?
A Knicks championship and also a Mets championship.
New Year's resolution. My New Year's resolution is I'm not going to make any promises which I cannot keep. That's a New Year's resolution.
Stop dabbing.
What do you look forward to in 2018?
I'm honestly just glad 2017 is over. It was pretty terrible.
Hopefully getting better grades.
My New Year's resolution is to finish my book and finally get it off to the publisher.
Great.
Wow, that really helped. Those are some great resolutions.
Maybe this year I'll try to play three sports.
I know someone who does that. Let's find out a little more about Mason Agostonelli.
I've been playing lacrosse since first grade, so probably over 10 years or so, I'd say. It's been a lot of fun, pretty much. I loved it from the start, and you know, obviously at a younger age, we weren't allowed to have contact, but as the contact started to build up, like the physicality of it, that's what I love about the sport. I think it should be really fun this year. You know, every year we're competitive, and especially like, you know, our varsity, JV, and freshman teams, all three teams are always competitive. This year we have as much of a chance as any other year we've had to win a state championship. Football, I've been playing since fifth grade is when we started. That's when we were actually allowed to start playing because we weren't allowed to play contact. But flag football, I started in third grade. We didn't have the best season or the season that we wanted to have. Obviously, our record didn't show it. But, you know, overall, just playing with the same guys, you know, and the seniors being really great leaders, we all got closer together this year. And I think even though our record didn't show it, like I said before, like, we all got closer, and that was probably the best part of the season. So, yeah, I started when I was four. I've always been based in Vermont, you know, skiing, most of my time skiing in Vermont. But, like, that's my, skiing is my passion, you know. I've been to Utah to ski, a bunch of different states in the Northeast to ski. I love it. I mainly ski at Stratton in Vermont, and recently I joined Ski Patrol, and that's been a blast. Yeah, so I'm looking forward to this year.
Wow, that was impressive. Thanks for Mason for sitting down with us to talk with us.
Hey, Steven, is Kylie Jenner actually pregnant?
No way.
Are you kidding? She totally is.
Let's settle this by seeing what the rest of the Pulse predicts for 2018.
Seahawks.
Patriots.
I think it's going to be the New England Patriots and the Los Angeles Rams.
I don't know, I'm going to give Falcons on that one. I want Falcons in the Super Bowl 100%.
I think the Steelers and the Patriots.
Probably the Raiders and the Cowboys.
The Patriots are a lock, and the Cowboys, if they win out, are going to be in the Super Bowl.
Patriots will once again return. And they will face off with the LA Rams.
The Patriots and the Eagles will definitely be in the Super Bowl this year.
Taylor Swift will win Album of the Year.
I think Album of the Year in 2018 will be Drake.
Khalid.
I'm gonna say Lil Uzi Vert.
I don't know, probably Ariana Grande.
Lil Uzi Vert, Love Is Rage 2.
I think SZA will win Album of the Year.
Album of the Year's gotta go to Travis Scott.
A fashion trend will be socks and sandals.
I think Louis Vuitton will be very popular in 2018.
Supreme.
The rolled up pants.
Bean boots are gonna come back.
People will start wearing their sweatpants outside of their socks.
Ryan and girls. Emily.
For boys, it's gotta be Jack, and for girls, Emily.
Baby name for girls, Olivia, for the fifth straight year. I think we'll hold the title. And for boys, I see Connor making a strong
run. Jared, I don't know.
For boys, let's make it Steven.
Audrey. Boys, Noah.
boys' names for girls is going to become popular in 2018?
The Avril Lavigne.
I'm going to say Beyonce.
Hit song, Lil Pump.
I don't know, like 21 Savage has been hot lately, like Future.
Kesha is coming back. Think about it. She's been gone for so long.
I can't wait to see if any of those predictions come true.
Me too. Looks like 2018 is going to be a great year here at CHS.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time at the Pulse.